What do you think, David?
So actually, two of these concepts would allow us to complete the previous proof, the oven mitt or the wooden spoon. The definition of oven mitt tells us that it protects against heat because it limits heat transfer. So using oven mitt, we can complete this proof. However, the wooden spoon allows us to do that too by just bypassing the thick sides and being made of clay altogether. The wooden spoon definition told us that if it has a handle, it protects against heat. We already knew that the object had a handle, so using that definition, we know that it protects against heat while ignoring the thick sides and that it's made of clay. So either of those would actually let us complete this proof.
There are a couple of other points to note about this exercise. An important question in knowledge-based AI is, what knowledge does one need? It's not a question of putting in a lot of knowledge into an AI program. Instead, the real question is, in order to accomplish a goal, what is the minimal amount of knowledge that the AI agent actually needs? Let's see how this applies here. The goal was to show that the object is a mug. Instead of putting in a lot of knowledge, the agent starts asking, what do we need in order to show that the object can protect against heat? What do we need in order to show that the object is stable? And then it goes about searching for that knowledge. The second point to note here is that depending on the background knowledge available, the agent would opportunistically build the right kind of causal proof. So if the agent knows about a wooden spoon, it will build this proof. If, on the other hand, the agent knew not about the wooden spoon, but about the oven mitt, then it would use this particular proof. Which proof the AI agent will build will depend upon the precise background knowledge available to it.